Today's psalm is from Psalm 42. And Psalm 42 is, in my opinion, one of the best psalms. And the reason why it's one of the best psalms is, one, it's just got such great words in it, but it's also so very real. And I love when human emotion just comes full spilling out towards God, because like I've said many times before, God can handle all of our emotions. And so in this psalm, you see it displayed. And so I'm going to read some of the verses and we'll talk about it, and then I'll continue to read. So Psalm 42 says this to begin with: as the deer pants for streams of water, so my soul pants for you, my God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When can I go and meet with God? So starting off today, is your soul thirsty? And if so, is it thirsty for God? Are you like a deer that is panting for streams of living water? Or are you being satiated by the world and its very temporary satisfaction? Here, this psalmist is desperate for more of God. Are we today desperate for more of God? It continues, and this is where he gets very real. He says, my tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me all day long, where is your God? For many of us, when we struggle with the really down times, the hard times, when we get into periods of depression, which happens, I think there are times when we feel bad about how we feel. We feel like we're not representing Jesus very well because of the state of our being at that moment. And sometimes for us, we can feel like people are watching us and judging us because maybe we don't have this shiny, happy face all the time. But I think here the psalmist understands that if there's one place that he can go, if there's one place he knows he won't be judged, it is to God. And God can listen and hear all of his emotions, all of his desires, all of his needs, all of his wants. And the psalmist here continues and he says, these things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I used to go to the house of the Lord under the protection of the Mighty One with shouts of joy and praise among the festive throng. And here the psalmist is recalling the good times. He is remembering when he was under the protection of God. And Chad did this really great sermon just a few weeks back on depression, and it talked about how we tell ourselves lies, or we might exaggerate what's happening to us right now because it just feels so terrible. And we remember the good days with longing, but right now it just seems like God's protection has gone. And that's a lie. And so one of the things that Chad talked about was refuting the lies, was exchanging the lies with God's truth. And then this is what I love that the psalmist does. He talks to himself and he says, why, my soul, are you downcast? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God. So he is very honest about the situation he's in. He's very honest about how he feels. He even believes that God's protection, in a sense, has left him. But then he reminds himself and he talks to himself and he tells his soul where to put its hope. And then he starts to praise God. And the beautiful thing about faith is you're thanking God in advance for what you do not see yet. And many of us, when we're going through really difficult times, we have to dig really, really deep to call out and to praise God in the midst of sheer agony. The psalmist mentions this further down when he says, deep calls to deep in the roar of your waterfalls. All your waves and breakers have swept over me. By day, the Lord directs his love. At night, his song is with me, a prayer to the God of my life. And so the psalmist goes back and he kind of goes back and forth. He says to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? And then at the end, he reminds himself and he talks to himself again and he says, why, my soul, are you downcast? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God. So here we see in the psalm this roller coaster of emotion. He's kind of up, he's desperate for God, but he's feels like God doesn't protect him, but then he remembers, and then he talks to his own soul, and he tells his soul to praise God, and then he talks about how God has forgotten him, and then at the end, he says the same thing again. He talks to his soul again, and he tells his soul to put his trust in God, and then he says, "For I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God." It's powerful. It's a powerful thing to do, that in the midst of agony and pain and misery and depression and feelings that don't necessarily generate praise, that we choose to praise him anyway. So today I encourage you, if you're feeling this way, to talk to yourself. Now, many people think that talking to yourself is a sign of being crazy. I think it's a sign of great mental health, actually. Talking to yourself is one of the best things you can do, I think, because you can tell yourself and you can remind yourself about God's truth, about who you are and about whose you are, that you are loved by a wonderful God who does have a great plan and purpose for your life. And even in the midst of it, that you may not understand that plan right in this moment, you believe that there is a bigger picture and that there is more going on far beyond what you can see. And so you trust him. And because you trust him, you praise him. So today, how are you doing? Where is your soul at? Does it thirst? Is it desperate for more of God? Is it dry? Is it deep, calling out to deep with all full range of emotions? Wherever you're at today, I just want to pray over you that your soul might thirst more for God. Let's pray. God, I thank you for this psalm. I thank you for its honesty. I thank you for the wisdom that there is in talking to ourselves, in talking to our own souls, and to remind ourselves that God is God. He is a living God, and he is a Savior, and that he is worthy of praise. And so I pray today that we would desire more of you, that we would in fact be desperate for you, the living water, and that you would come, and that you would come and satiate our souls beyond our wildest dreams, that God, that no matter what is going on, no matter what the circumstances, we can trust you and we can praise you. In your amazing name we pray.